now I'm headed to a meetup hosted by Sarah Dici. She's a big YouTuber. She's been a huge inspiration. Hopefully I get to meet her for a little bit.
I don't wanna see you cry. You don't have to feel this emptiness. She said, I love you till the day that I die. Well, maybe she's right. Cause I don't wanna feel like I'm not me. And to be honest, I don't even know why I let myself get down in the food.
Well, I think what you just said is so key. It's about doing the work on the back end so that you're in the right places. I get the question, how did you meet Gary? I'm sure you get this a lot too. And I didn't reach out to him. I did the work beforehand, so I was in a place where it just happens, right? And I think that's kind of the beauty of it. That's the beauty of New York. If you put in the work, or wherever you are, honestly, those opportunities are much more likely to happen.
Take it more serious. I was so hyped when I started getting dislikes on my videos and like negative comments. Not that there's rarely any, but like when those ones would come in, like, well, that means that people who like don't really know me, like when I was getting 100 views on a video, I was like, cool, like my videos are reaching new people. That's good. So I kind of took it as a good thing, but they're always just like trolls too, so I never took it to heart. It was just like, you know.
But in terms of it hurt, beyond that, there's only 10 comments that are bad. And I start to think, I think I've commented on a Casey Neistat video maybe once, like twice in my entire life, but I owe so much of what I'm doing to him. And so I think you have to keep in the perspective that like, comments are not everything because it's such a small fraction of your audience. And so do take it with a grain of salt though, because it's like if you're expanding your audience and you are growing beyond what you're used to, you are gonna get hate. So you can kind of like, that's like, okay, I'm doing something right, can't take it to heart. But
and it's usually always like, for the most part, I never let it get to me, because it is always usually like stupid.
Say something. If you like someone, like, leave a supportive comment. Because it really does. Like,
it really does.
It really
every
does
comment
make a difference.
I would
yeah.
say that for all of us that we at least go through every single
yeah.
one.
Yeah.
Because my piece of advice was maybe try to avoid looking at all the comments. I do usually, but I scroll down a certain amount, and then there's like this thing in YouTube where it's basically like, don't scroll any further. Because down below is where YouTube, for some reason, usually push. They can recognize keywords that are usually hateful. So they push those comments usually farther down. So I try not to scroll past a certain point, but also if you just like think about the psychology behind somebody who does hate, it's like usually it stems from insecurity, and you're stronger than that person who's hating on you, so you try to just think of him as a lesser person.
Well, look, yeah, it's like if people have time to leave hate on something, it's like, what are they doing with their lives? Like, feel bad for them.
Especially if you're not doing anything like seriously bad.
Yeah.
It's like,
yeah, if you're a terrible person, like take the hint. But,
it's corny advice, but like if they hate, they're just jealous. It's every single time. It's like
they hate us because they ain't us, right?
Right.
Insane. We're going to the World Trade Center. Sorry, I think it's closed. We have reservations.